Ladies and gentlemen, I welcome you to the finals of the Fog Goblin Goblet. Oh man, if you haven't watched the previous two games, get your ass back into my channel and look at those two games. They're both freaking over 2 hours long. I was pretty much dying. It was something. So I think this one's gonna live up to the hype. Go beat Torjred in an ultra close game in the first round. It came down to the day limit. Oh my god. And then after that, Hogat faced Inkagark. Inkagark had the better KD, but Hogat was able to go through with having more properties and slowly beating him by a war of attrition. And by the missiles, oh man, and Inkagark loved that lucky last. He loved that lucky last. But anyway, we are here at the finals now. Between Go7 and Hogat, the number one seed versus the number two seed, but it wasn't easy getting here. It wasn't easy getting here. And let me just say this. I think Hogat played better than Go in the first round. Let me just put it out there. I thought Hogat played seamlessly in the first round. So I'm not entirely sure he's going to win this final right here. Hogat did play in a more conventional map known as Redemption World, which is in the Global League. So maybe he had more of an opening idea than Go did for his map, which wasn't. But man, these guys have impressed me. I've been impressed with all the players so far. Got a few questions. Who's going to win? Will I run out of water for the third time and die of dehydration? Will we have another two-hour game? So, man, let's talk about this map right here. It's called Desperate Breakout, and I haven't played this game in a long time. And the reason why I chose this game for the finals is it is the first game that I ever lost a Global League match on. This is going back to, like, July or August of 2021. I was Sonya. I picked Sonya for every single map, every single match I had at the very beginning of my Advanced Wars career because I didn't understand tiers very well, and I was bested by an Eagle player, I remember, on this map right here. And ever since, I've kept this map in the back of my head. I was like, I'm never going to forget this map. This map is nuts. I need to learn it eventually. Then immediately after I lost that, it went out of the rotation, so I never saw it again. But I just want to say this. This map here is nutty because it is a one base versus a two base and an airport. It is basically the same thing as the Lash matchup. Remember that game where it was nutty and it was like just all out HQ rush? This is one base, two base, and an airport, but this in fog. And there's comm towers. There's four comm towers. So we're going to have even more power. We're going to have a 20% boost. There's going to be less walls. Just raw power just smashing into each other. This is freaking chaos. I love this map. I'm bad at this map, or I was bad a year ago at this point almost. But I just love it. I just love the chaos. I love the smashing. I love not being stally. They're going to be overrun. Who's going to be overrun in their base first? Then they gotta shift in the middle, because both sides are gonna lose their one base, but who's gonna lose it first? And then will you be able to shift your forces over to rescue your one base before it is too late? This map just has it all. I just love this map. The HQ is not particularly safe as well, but yeah, it's just nutty. One thing I also want to add right here, the COs. Go7 was prohibited from using Kindle in this round because he used Kindle in the first round, so there he chose Rachel for this map. Seeing as it's small, seeing as it's live, you don't have time to prepare for the missiles. As we saw in the Inkagark game, didn't have time to use the move planner. The missiles were powering down on him, just beating him to death. Whereas Hogat, on the other hand, used Rachel in the first round, not allowed to use Rachel this turn, now using Kindle, which is also a very strong pick. When you have these rushy-type maps, you want aggressive COs with strong day-to-day powers, Kindle, Lash, but Rachel is also very strong because of her super CO power, so... Ah, man, this is going to be close. I think Rachel is the better CO in this matchup right here, personally, but it's very close. And Go and Hogat, like I said, Hogat looked more impressive, but Go has the more longer track record and has beaten Hogat more times. So this is really tough. I don't know what's going to happen. I don't know who's going to run out of time. Is it going to come to 30 days again? Yeah, so anyway, without further ado, let us begin. And the game begins! One thing I forgot to mention, Rachel is sort of a counter to Kindle in terms of repairs, because as you may have remembered, Kindle does 3 damage during Urban Blight, and Rachel repairs 3 HP when she gets repaired instead of 2. So, little mini counter maybe, but I don't know if it's really going to come too much into play. But another thing I want to mention, in this sort of situation, do you want to give up your base, or do you want to build a mega tank? But then it would keep sapping funds from you, you know what I mean? Remember the game I had versus Firem? He kept his base for longer, but it kept sapping 5,000, 6,000, etc. funds from his base every single turn. So we'll see what happens here. Will they just willingly give up the base? Or will they just build a mega tanks, neo tanks, whatever they can, just to hold off as long as possible. So let's see right here. Also, you start off with one comp tower and you can get a second one. So this is currently in the hands of Hogat, so Go can get that for temporarily. He's already building a recon to exert some pressure on Hogat down here. I agree with that. You want to put as much pressure early on. Heck, you don't even want to allow any more than them getting these two properties right there. It's going to be, you want to really like wean them off, or like cut them off right here. Don't allow them to get in the middle. Just cut them off on this little sphere over here. Let them get these four properties, and then don't let them get that. Don't let them get that. Same goes over here with Hogat. So you really want to go on the offensive, do as much damage as you possibly can early on. Looks like he's already going for probably this base before the comp tower. I don't think you'd go for the comp tower immediately. But yeah, this is going to be nutty. I think that Hogat probably be going for a recon. If not a recon, probably an early tank or battlecopter. Battlecopters, I mean, once you overwhelm with battlecopters and tanks, you can't really counter tanks with a medium tank anymore, because then you have a copter to worry about that can base block you. So you also have to build Nantair. So you want to infuse air units into your attack, a multi-pronged attack from air and from the land at the same time. Yeah, going for the property first. Both of them using, you know, just a minimal amount of time so far. Good job. Going for the attack right here, getting repairs. I like that. So it's going to force Hogat to spend $200 in repairs for that infantry, cutting him off from maybe an earlier build he had in mind. So the recon already doing some work. There could be an early tank over here. I doubt it. It's only turn day 5 right now, so I doubt there's an early tank, but there could be an early tank. There is ideas for a tank on the weak side, or you can just go give up willy-nilly, just only build infantry, maybe a mech or something, and then just give it up. But other people might want to build a weak side tank first, just to like hold their ground for longer, and then slowly shift all their forces to their strong side. There's also this pipe seam in the middle that maybe they'll be able to reinforce this 2 base to their 1 base if they have time. But I think he's going to be overrun. Both of them will probably be overrun before they can connect these pipe seams. That's how it went in my games, at least. I was definitely overrun before I was able to get through all these pipe seams. No refreshers yet. I'm glad to see we have no refreshing pop-ups yet. I don't want to jinx myself, but I like that. Pressing that all last time is pretty annoying. So I think you can't be aggressive here. Look, you can get these two front properties. You're losing that shit. You want to go back here and get the safe one right there. That's what I do 100%. Your penguin is 100% dead if you try to grab this. So Go, no doubt, he'll go back to this safe one right here, where you can hold it on to longer. You can hold on to these three properties much longer than you would be able to hold on to any of these properties. Because, look, I jinxed myself. There's the first pop-up. But, yeah, you don't want to be aggressive in the face of a two base. Some beginner players might think, oh, I'm going to be aggressive, get some extra properties, and yeah, hold on to them. No, you're not going to do that. And a two base versus one base setup. With an airport, too. Two base and an airport setup. So Go very smart here. You don't go for this one. Remember, you go for the back one. Go for the safe properties on your weak side. On your strong side, hell yeah. Go for the middle. Go for this corner over here. Go for this front one. Don't go for that one yet. You know, take your time, you know, going farther in your strong side. So building a tank. So Go's just going all out on the strong side. And I don't like to see mechs normally. That's usually the mark of a... I don't like seeing mechs on a weak side this early. So I'm not sure if I agree with that from Hogat, but maybe he has the ideas to plant it somewhere or maybe break the pipe seam early. I probably have a better idea how to address this map than I do, especially back when I was 900 or 1,000 or whatever I was back in the day. So we'll see if that mech pays off. We got that nice vision of it so far, so we'll see what happens right there. Go going for the early tank, probably going to follow up with another tank or maybe a B-copter immediately. Yeah, Hogat's just going for infantry. Infantry and one mech, so... We'll see if the mech pays off. I mean, it could fight off a recon. Maybe that's why he built the mech, just for the recon's sake. So we'll see what comes to play here. Goes about to get 20% increase in firepower. Hogat probably will be able to grab this as well, so... The thing is, you grab this thing, and then it eventually goes back into the hands of the stronger side player anyway, so... Getting this comp tower is just temporary. But you will eventually have 20% increase in firepower, or 30% temporarily if you do have... if you manage to get three under your control temporarily, because usually the opponent's going to get their strong side one. So we'll see if these comp towers come into play. Probably not very much. Mostly going to come into play, will these pipe seams be broken in time to reinforce, or will they be completely overwhelmed over here? And he's only building infantry, so there's got to be a big-ass army over here. Go knows that. That's why you don't go for up here. Maybe if you see two tanks over here, maybe you get a little more aggressive, but probably even then not. But you see nothing over here, so it's just, you know, there's going to be two tanks, battlecopter, recons, artillery. Artillery also very strong on a 2-versus-1 base thing because they can base lock, and that's really effective if they build a medium tank, if they build a neo tank or mega tank or whatever. And artillery will be able to fire on that base over and over again, and at the very least causing repairs. So artillery, very strong on the strong side. Look, just as soon as I said that, Go builds an artillery. I swear he's not stream sniping because I'm recording this while they're playing. They have no idea what I'm saying. Just one of those, you know, telepathy things, you know, it's just agreed on. When you're on strong side, you build more artillery than you typically would. So recon coming in, probably going to finish that off with another unit, yep, and then start capping. Like I said, there's just a flood of units coming in. Although this one is dubious, because he knows goes right there. I don't think the mech will be able to get there in time that he built. The mech is probably just going to chill in this mountain or something, maybe. But that property right there is probably going to be stopped unless there's a tank like right here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Oh, no, it's got to be closer. It's got to be right here to fire back if that recon does attack. And he sees the recon, so he'll probably be moving something in range as well, but there will be a follow-up attack. The thing is, this is on a city, and he is Kindle Hogad is, so that recon will die in one shot to a tank. No questions asked, no rules. So we will see, but we'll go interrupt. I would assume he would interrupt right here, because it is a contested property over here. It's not a given property by any means, and he probably wants to maintain the property advantage. So I assume he would sack if need be and bring his tank down, but he might not. He might just play it safe. He might just be scouting what's going on. He could bring his recon back to this property and scout what's going on. He's building every single turn. Having that intel on what your opponent is building every single turn is pretty helpful. And also note that Go has this property and Hogad does not have this property. So Go has an incoming lead from what's visible right now. We don't really know what's going on beyond the scenes. Maybe he's already captured this property faster because he didn't build an early recon like Go did. So you don't really know what's going on at this point. Both of them have gobs of time. Neither of them fretting too much about time. Go also built a mech. He saw the mech. I guess he wanted to build his own mech. Everyone who's cool is doing it. Maybe he wants to blast this pipe scene. That doesn't make sense. You want to blast this pipe scene so you can reinforce. Yeah, people build mechs. Okay. I'm not a big mech-y kind of guy. I remember building a mech on this map and I lost because of it. So, and I know in Vadoom or Vidhalla or whatever the hell, mechs aren't good. Like, I'm not a huge mech guy. Unless I'm Sammy, I'm just not building mechs. Let me be honest. Like, unless it's a small mountainous map, I'm really just not building mechs. So we'll see what he builds here. Maybe artillery? That's kind of dubious, maybe. I don't know. I honestly have no clue. Maybe an anti-air, because you know there's going to be a bad copter eventually. But do you want to invest that much into your weak side is the question. He does not. He just wants to build a mech. So, yeah, building, you want to mix in the air and the land. These three units right here, enough to overcome the mech and infantry. There's no way he can stop that. He can build an anti-air, he can build a tank, but these three combined are just going to be too much. And he's getting the comm tower much later, Hogad is. So Hogad, I would say, is behind on the capture game so far, but he's probably going to be able to punish this recon. He saw it in advance. Oh, he's going for the reinforcement thing. He's not going for the overrun. He's going for the reinforce and keep this bottom over here. He's going for the more traditional approach. Me, I like just beating the shit out of someone and beating their weak side and they beat my weak side. I just like that feel. Maybe I'm a caveman deep down. Maybe I'm a baboon brain kind of guy. But that primal instinct to smash things, that's just in my brain. Whereas Hogat's like, let's make this a more civil war over here. We don't want to deal with this sort of trash. So he wants to make a triangle of influence over here versus a triangle of influence over here, which is to each their own. I'd rather beat the shit out of someone, but you know, it is what it is. Probably gonna bring no punish. Ooh, that recon got away with murder right there. This recon is doing shit. This recon is going places. That's a good recon. That's, dare I say, close to getting a Best Buy gift card worth of stuff. Right now, it's probably got a $5 Panera gift card to buy their shitty cold soups or something. But right now, it's on its way to Best Buy. It might even be able to afford half of a Wii game soon, dare I say. A Wii game from 2008, it can almost buy half of that. So that recon's getting a lot of value. Go right now is probably like, I lost that. I'm not going to interrupt that. Plus, it's Kindle. You don't want to interrupt a Kindle cap on a city. That infantry would die. This infantry would die. It wouldn't matter. So right now, you just want to keep your unit count up. Rather than focusing on preventing him capping properties, you want to focus on keeping your unit count up. You want to have more units in defense so you can create more walls, to delay the inevitable. So don't worry about income. He's doing fine on income. You'll get your income back over here. It's all about unit count. Let me hammer that home. All about unit count. You can see, you can capture this property over here. Who gives a shit? Just give up this property. Having this mountain in control is also crucial. So I'm assuming Kogat will get control of this mountain. Then you can see what your opponent is building. You can see basically everything around the base and plan accordingly. It's almost like a cheat code. You can just see everything. They won't have any shot to like plan anything. You won't be able to hide any units. Oh. Dude, go, what are you doing, bro? I don't agree with that at all. I think Go's getting pretty cocky. I think Hogat's gonna punish this, no doubt about it. We'll see though, because Hogat's about to have Go has a 30%, or no, not quite yet, doesn't have 30% yet, but he's doing the exact opposite of what I wanted him to do. These tankers are gonna get destroyed, they're gonna be decimated. Alright, I guess he's feeling comfortable because he saw the artillery over here. He knows he invested 6k sunk cost over here to bust this pipe seam. Maybe he thinks there's not enough things over here, but there's going to be at least one tank. There's probably going to be a battlecopter. Both those penguins are dead. Maybe that recon's even dead. But the recon does have some overlap from the tank, so. And there's also a mech here that Hogat did spot, so he knows there is a mech there. So that recon will probably be left alone. No one wants to touch a pesky little recon that's near a mech. But these two are both dead. And that anti-air cannot reach a copter if a copter does choose to kill these. That is 100% dead. That penguin, the full HP of tanks or something, is going to go on top and kill it. So, artillery. There you go. Didn't even need to. In one of these forests, it looks like this one right here, I would wager. Or maybe on this road. Yeah, see, those are just dead. Okay, you got your 1k, but you lost 2 units in the process. I'm not a huge fan of that. But, I don't know. Feeling a little cocky. I mean, he's a great player, so I don't know. But the thing is, Hogat forgot to cap his comm tower. I do this all the time. I do all my things and like, shit, I could have gotten 10% more firepower the whole time. And he's going to realize right now. Once you do something in the area, they're like, oh, oopsies. Happens to the best of us. Luckily, there wasn't a major battle going on. Although he did fire on this pipe seam before getting the comm tower, so that also did less damage to the pipe seam as well. Kind of frustrating, but you know, it happens. But luckily for him, it's not a big deal at this point in the game. This tank will be able to attack this recon, but as we've seen, there is probably an artillery in this forest right here on this road. My bet's on having it in this forest. See, artillery, strong side. Everyone knows that in the higher levels. It's just kind of intuition. We don't really talk about it. You just know. You just know that artillery better on 2 base versus 1 base. When you have numbers and a lot more infantry than your opponent, you can really abuse infantry walls, and with that, artillery just become that much better. On your weak side, if you only have like 2 penguins, that's why you want to keep the unit count up. If you get your unit count down, you just lost 2 units here. They could have served as more blockers for artillery or, dare I say, a rockets hiding in this property over here that defends the base. You could build a rockets there, and then they can't even get through right there, and then you can build like a medium tank over there, and then you have 2 big beefy units defending. So that's just an idea, but with all these units dying, you're not going to have as many walls. So Hogat is definitely ahead on KD right now, but he seems to be behind in terms of income. Because he does not have this property. I don't think he has this property. Maybe he does. And Go does have all 3 of these contested properties, whereas Hogat has at most 1. So that early recon really paid off for Go. I like recons in 2 versus 1 base, and I like artillery in 2 versus 1 base. I hope you guys learned from that. It might not be common knowledge, but it's just very strong. You want a lot of pressure. Okay, building on the weak side, it's understandable, but I would have liked that better if he had 2 more penguins, you know what I'm saying? Like, maybe you put the artillery... Actually, no, you can't even get over here. There's rivers, so you can't reach here except for infantry, but I don't know. I would have liked 2 more penguins here, maybe. So you have 5 penguins defending the artillery, and he's not going to get there very easily. Hell, you can build another artillery. 5 penguins and 2 artillery. It's hard to break through that, even on your strong side. Plus an anti-air. See, that's a pretty formidable defense. But 3 penguins? Not so hard. Not so hard to break through. 1 attack here, 1 attack here, you already get the artillery. You know, 1 attack here, 1 attack here. One attack from the city over here, it's a 1-hit KO on that penguin. And then that anti-air is exposed. Copter going in the middle, I like that. not really focusing too much over here. I think he knows that Hogat will have reinforcements coming from the side, so he's deciding instead to focus on the middle. Very interesting. This is not what I expected. I thought this was going to be more of a base race. But these guys, they must have agreed to before the game. Oh, please. Base races are for baboon brains. Us high society, kindles and rachels, don't dabble with that. We're not dabblers, we're stabblers. I'm sure they said that word for word before the match. No doubt about it. Scarfing down some caviar and some Pinot Grigio, slurping some of that. So, yeah, so we got a pretty tame game so far. And I don't like tame. I think Hogat's going to bring down the sledgehammer soon. I think Hogat's going to bring down the sledgehammer over here. I got a feeling. There's not much going on over here except for an artillery. I think the sledgehammer's going to come in and boom, like, knock some teeth out. Oh, I can't wait to see that. Not because I want Go to lose, but because I want to see some action. So far, pretty tame. Pretty tame. Higher level players, pretty tame. Let's see what Hogat does. I have faith in the Hogat being aggressive here. His aggression paid off when he faced Inkagark. Recon right there. Now he sees everything. Actually, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. He does not see what this base... Actually, he probably has an infantry in this mountain. Let's be honest. He probably has an infantry in the mountain, so he can see everything going on. He sees three penguins and, you know, only one lane of attack to have killed that penguin, so he won't be able to get to it in one turn unless he has a copter to circle around or an anti-air to one-shot it. But he does have two comm towers, so one-shots are more easy to acquire. So we'll see. But yeah, he busts through the pipe seam, so he's definitely doing the approach. He's probably got a shit ton of tanks over here if he's confident capping this. Tank is out of position, only the recon and the copter are in position. You can bet your ball sack that Hogat has an anti-air. The question is it in range to protect against this copter? Because he does not see it yet. Go smartly, put his copter right here, out of the vision of this infantry, so maybe Hogat has no idea. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, his recon didn't even see this copter. This copter is literally surrounded where it could be seen by things, but it luckily is in exact perfect spot. Unsure if it was by luck or by skill, probably a combination of the two. But yeah, here comes a swarm of shit. I'm expecting probably two artillery and a copter maybe, though he sees the anti-air. Maybe he's going to divert his copter instead to the middle, similar to what Go did. So, wouldn't be surprised by that. Go, not even tickling the Hogat over here, not even tickle. So, yeah, Hogat's got a shitload of time. Hogat's a faster player than Go7. He's not the fastest, he's not Tordred speed, but he's still quite quick compared to Go7, compared to Inkagark, etc. Go7's turn, and we shall see. I would probably sack the recon to stop that cap at this point. Get some vision, sack the recon, and then move your artillery up right there, and then start consolidating around. That wouldn't be a bad idea. Start an attack, see if you can control... Oh, yeah, get vision first. Okay, so now you can see everything. Would have been easier to get this vision of the mountain, and you can see just basically just as much stuff. You might not see this infantry in the mountain over here, but you see everything else. So these mountains are pretty great. Recons aren't 100% needed for vision in this map. They're more needed for harassment purposes, because this mountain provides perfect vision. And if you're lucky, you can get both of these mountains, and then it's basically, you know, everything that's going on. So mountains are pretty useful in this map right here. But it looks like Go is not going to interrupt an all-in. Maybe he will with half of his army to interrupt that gap, but it looks like he's actually leaning towards to going down over here, just judging by the recon. But you never know. He could shift over. Yeah, he's going for the cap. And Hogat, he's not going to sack these things to stop the cap. I know that. I've seen enough from Hogat. Or he's going to use the unit count to make sure he has the proper unit count before dealing with this threat over here. The question is, where is Hogat's units? We have no intel on where his units are. Go does not have enough vision going on over here, so we don't really see what's going on. Oops. Okay. So Go did interrupt this cap over here. He was feeling ballsy. I'm assuming we're going to see this. Okay, yes. Double hit over here, finishing off. Probably move the artillery in position. Sees the recon over there. But now recon will die unless he moves this artillery in position. Although, ooh, wow. That artillery is lucky. It will not be seen by that recon right there. So it can slide into the forest right there. that sexy little forest, and then you can shift your tank over too. Oh, he's dabbling. He's dabbling a little bit. He's dabbling. He wants to cover both over here and over there. And, oh, smart. Oh, no, not smart. He sees the... I would have left that copter one space higher, because he can see it now, where it is, and calculate where to put all his units now. Whereas, if he kept it out of vision of Hogat, then Hogat would have no idea where it is. Okay, so it looks like he's... Is he dabbling? Is he gonna put the artillery here? Because if he doesn't put anything over here, that recon's just free meat. So we'll see. Like I said, Go's more focusing more on property and income right now, where Hogat seems to be focusing more on KD. And I'm in the old school method where I think KD is more important. I think having more units is more important than having income. But Hogat is retaking this over here, so he won't have the income lead for very much longer. He'll have a slight lead because Hogat does not have this one, and Go does have this one over here. So he will have, you know, a bit of a lead income, but very slight. It's not a high income map, but it's also not a low income map. This mech is just chilling. See, these mechs aren't doing jack shit. Like, look at these things. They're so useless. I mean, they're sort of like a deterrent right now from attacking these three, but like, not really. They bought them so early. They could have bought them like a turn ago on day 10 instead of day like 4 or 5, and really bought something nicer. Like, I don't know, even earlier artillery or a tank over here to pressure earlier on to punish that recon that attacked. I'm not a mech guy. Another artillery, maybe? He could just go like all out, like... It's like a guy inside of like a... Oh shit! Building a medium tank. It's like a guy who's cornered in a house with like a shotgun. Like, eh, bring it on! Like, it's a last stand kind of feeling. But yeah, he's going for the medium tank. So we are seeing... I was hoping to see this. The big beefy units trying to hold off, where the big army of numbers swarms in. This is what I like to see. I thought we were going to have some, you know, weenie kind of stuff going on. This isn't a weenie hut. We want to see some battles. We want to see some overwhelming, brutalized action. We're not trying to have a conventional war where you handshake at the beginning. Alright, here's the rules. No chemical weapons. No hurting innocent civilians. No, we're not doing that. We're blasting everything. There's going to be some innocent civilians dying. They're throwing some chemicals. There's going to be some chlorine, some fluorine. I don't even know more than 10 elements in the periodic table of elements, but they're using all those. Argon. That's all I know. But now we're seeing some action. That recon is deady dead. No retaliation from Go because this artillery opted not to go there. So definitely prioritizing the base over the city over there. I feel like he could have prevented that city for longer if he wanted to, but Hogat has perfect intel because he sees all these units with that mountain over here. Like I said, mountains are crucial. This mountain right here and this mountain right here are just absolutely crucial. Recons are good in the center because you can't see shit, but on the sides over here, the mountains are king for vision. So Hogat's got to be pretty happy that he actually got this property right here without any real damage. And look, Go only was able to attack this infantry right there, so it wasn't a big deal. So, I wish I could check KD right now, but I'm pretty sure Hogat's up like 5-2 or something of the sort. Maybe even 1. I'm not even sure if he even killed a single Hogat unit. If I'm being perfectly honest, I think he was able to repair and heal all of them. And are we going to see a medium tank over here? Because you can bet Hogat has control of the mountain. He sees that medium tank. There's no doubt about it. He sees that medium tank. Is he going to build his own medium tank? Is he going to build an artillery? He's going to build an artillery. That was my thought process, because artilleries are cheaper. The thing is, there's two angles of attack right here. You can attack with a recon, you can attack with a tank, and then the copter can attack too. And then you have the issue of you will attack the artillery. But then I guess you can just withdraw it, and then you have a weakened artillery. The thing is, Rachel, if you have this ball over here with all these infantry, with all these artillery, oh god, this is why Rachel is the stronger pick overall, in my opinion. You're gonna have these balls on your weak side, some big beefy balls, and you're gonna get blasted by missile silos. 2-3 missiles are gonna strike you, and it's not gonna be pretty. Whoa, Go going on the offensive on his weak side. This is unheard of. What? Man, Go is feisty this game. Whoa. I mean, he must think Hogad is all the way over here. I don't know. If Hogad has a punish here, it's not going to be pretty. But the question, does he have a punish? I don't know, honestly. We don't know. That's why I kind of like this live, where you can't see. Like, in a replay, at the end, you can kind of see what your opponent's doing. I don't really like that. I like to see, like, only your units, so you have no idea, that mystique. You don't know what's going on, the mystery behind it. So I have no idea if Hogat's units are over here or over here. There could be a big punish. Hogat could have a shit ton of artillery and stuff ready to attack, to pounce. He could have a bomber for all we know. Or he could just have a whole bunch of tanks over here. And it looks like Go is not going to be pushing in here to do the 2-hit KO on an infantry and then attack the artillery. He is instead choosing to, I guess, more methodical push, or get this recon in the center. Like I said, recons are more useful in the center because there's no mountains. Whereas the sides over here, you got all the vision you need on this mountain. Just put this penguin on this, plop it on this mountain right here, and you're golden. You just gotta sit there and stay on the mountain, stay golden, penguin boy. So, yeah, and this mech has done jack shit, and that mech has done jack shit. The mechs, I tell you, they sucky suck. That's why he was on the offensive. That's why. He was feeling good because he's going to have a medium tank chain. Oh. So maybe he's like faking out Hogat, throwing all this stuff, and is like, actually, I'm going to go for the middle. Maybe that's what he's doing. Does the fake out and then goes to the middle? No, not a terrible idea. I don't know. I'm just curious about these two medium tanks because Hogat, let's not forget, Hogat has pretty much he's actually behind on income. Hogat's behind on income, but he's going to have similar income regardless. So all this 32,000 in funds, Hogat's going to have 32,000 somewhere else. So there might be a medium tank, there might be a bomber, there might be, God, a pipe runner? No, there's not going to be a pipe runner, it's not viable. But, like, when you have a lot of money to spend, your opponent's probably going to have a lot of money to spend. So I'm wondering where all of those units are. Are they in take the form of copters? Do they take the form of... We don't know. So we'll see. See if he gets punished over here, Go7 does. Because Hogat has perfect vision of what's going on here. He doesn't see the anti-air anymore, but he knows it's there. He saw it there earlier. So he sees two medium tanks. Okay, so Hogat's probably got a whole shit ton of army right here. Although he saw Go retreat. So he knows Go retreated, so he probably knows that there's probably going to be another... This is looking like a front shift. Like, ooh. Oh, man. Go. Man, this is high-level play shit. He just knows too much stuff, man. He's just... His tactics. He baited Hogat to invest heavily over here and think everything was over here, and then he just front shifted over. Damn. Wow. Okay. Because he's got two medium tanks over here, most of his army right there. I'm wondering where Hogat's majority of his army is. You can just take this mountain. If I'm Hogat, I'm taking this mountain. Seeing that there's nothing there at all. I would have done that first, though. Get vision. Do that at the beginning of the turn. Get this mountain, see that there's nothing, and then you know, there's probably a shit ton of forces, like, in the middle before you do this attack over here. Because, that tank's dead 100%, and then there's a whole ton of counterplay. And there could be a pincer strike coming from Go, these two medium tanks rolling into the center. Go has a really good start, I'm impressed. I was wondering what he was doing, he's been sacking a lot of units and whatnot, but I'm impressed. It's hard to impress me when he's already the best fog player ranked, so. We'll see, I'm wondering where all that money is. Where is the money Hogat has? Where is that extra 32,000 funds that we don't see? If not more. He's probably got an artillery there. Okay, so he's probably got an artillery in that forest, I would assume. Maybe a second one over here. You're not just going to go in there blindly like that with this tank. You're going to have backup from an artillery. There's probably copters as well right here. Maybe some copters over here, just like being able to swing around. So... It seems pretty apparent that Go7 will not be able to overrun this base easily since that pipe seam has been busted. But at the same time, he's not really pressing Go7s who hasn't busted the pipe seam. So, Yeah, let's see what, I think this is going to be a punishing turn for... Oh, now he's busting it. Takes his two turns from the medium tank. Man, I thought they were going to just start blasting, man. They tricked me, too. It was like, oh, I'm gonna actually fight over here. Yeah, we're gonna have a nice brawl. Psych. I'm also busting the pipe scene. We're gonna have a triangle at the bottom versus a triangle at the top. It's like, ugh, really? Also, Go can afford to have this game get more stally than Hogat can because he is Rachel. Rachel eclipses Kindle when it comes to long games because Kindle's all about the day-to-day. Urban Blight's great and all at the beginning when, oh, instead of 14,000, I got 12,000 from repairs. But, like, at the end when you have a lot of units and stuff, a covering fire is going to do a lot more damage than an Urban Blight is. So expect Rachel to sort of eclipse Kindle as the game goes on. So it's in Hogat's best interest to make this game end early. He has to be the aggressor in this situation, which is uncomfortable. I mean, it's easier to be on the defensive or setting the pace of the game, rather, than it is being on the offensive and just desperately trying to beat the other player as fast as possible. So this mech did come into play. This mech did swing around, finally do something, gets the KO from the city. You just have to be aware there's going to be an artillery there. We all know that. It's there. So he's probably debating what to do with these copters over here. Is it worth it to get in there and just all out in the center over there? And it appears to me that he is opting to go for the center. He's going all out. Maybe start to surround. No, he doesn't have enough units. He only has three more units that can attack. So he could kill off this and get vision on the force, but he won't be able to actually get a hit off on the artillery in the same turn. So it looks like a little mini attack. So he's probably going to fire his artillery back on the tank and they'll draw even. Yeah, it's so obvious there's an artillery in the forest, but he sees a copter not in range of his other copter right there. You don't really want to leave that city exposed for a Kindle, though, because it's going to lead to a lot of one-shots. I mean, he's probably just going to one-shot the mech with, I don't know, take your pick of units. But Urban Blight is incoming if he chooses to use it. He can hold on to it for longer if he wants to. A lot of the time in Fog, you can really fake out an opponent. Maybe you want to hold on to an Urban Blight later when your opponent isn't expecting it. Sometimes people just build three infantry the turn they expect the Urban Blight, so there's minimal damage done. So sometimes you want to hold on to it later when they're building, like, neo-tanks and bombers and stuff. Okay. Going in. Go is going in. So, going all out. We are seeing an early battle. Unfortunately for him, this medium tank will not come into play in time. Unless this copter attacks, this mech attacks, and, like, a few other factors come in to kill this, pipe seat. Oh! If he brings the... There we go. Always with the backup plan, this Go 7. Always with the backup plan, this medium tank will come into play. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And we'll be able to get to one of these two spots right here. So, man, okay. He's probably going to retreat this medium tank over here since it is exposed now. And there's no backup from the other medium tank. And Hogat knows this. I'm wondering how strong this Hogat counterattack is going to be. We know the recons, or the artillery is going to shoot that tank probably. One shot that mech with something on the city. Probably get an anti-air to kill that copter over there. This other copter will do something or other. Goat does not have an anti-air over here. But luckily for him, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I think there's a forest. So it only was unfortunately for Go, this anti-air does only cover these spaces right here. So that kind of sucks for him. But could be worse. Could be have no coverage at all. Has a copter to fight back if need be. You don't really want to put this on the city right now because Urban Blight's coming. It's going to get to a 7 HP. So I understand why he's not covering up like he normally would. He's probably going to build another anti-air this turn because that one's really out of position. But Go is really debating. He's getting low on time. He's 10 minutes less than Hogat. This is kind of getting to like the Tordred game. Thing was, Go is really... his stamina has gotten a lot better. His play didn't really suffer when he was running out of time versus Tordred. He basically kept it at that high level the entire time. I thought it was going to sink from rushing and stuff. His quality of his move choice would be bad, but no. It's been really crisp. Have you seen these like bait and switches? Front switches? This whole thing with the pipe seam bursting and just in time, literally in time for this certain attack over here? Like, that's just... It's crisp, man. Oh, oops. Okay, so there was apparently a lull in the game, and if you skip forward, it's Hogat's turn. He has not used Urban Blight yet. It looks like Go7 did interrupt this city over here. Looks like Hogat is going all in. Go built an anti-air on this side over here. I thought he would build it over here where it was easier to reinforce, but choosing to get an anti-air over here, I guess, to cover this medium tank would make sense. I can't really blame that. So we can cover the center and also the side over here, because this medium tank is pretty exposed. So how does he have vision? How does Go? Oh yes, the pound. That's how he sees it. So Hogat's going all in. The artillery did fire on the tank. So not the biggest fight ever. I mean, that copter is dead, and that copter will live. So one will die, one will live. Pretty equal exchange right here. Evil exchange. So playing into Go's hand. So Hogat's got to start worrying about the infantry wall or infantry ball. And it looks like he has one prepared. So the Rachel Super, luckily for him, Go did not choose to press over here and overtake him when he would be forced to have the ball. So the ball right here doesn't really matter that much. If I'm Go and I want an evil plan, maybe I use the super, back off. Then all these are like a 1 or 4 HP. Then you take this thing. That would be kind of evil and smart. You wait till you're super and this is all softened up for you. You just ignore it for a bit. Then when you see it's weak, you strike at the right moment and take the base. That could be another play right there. But I would doubt something of the sort. It looks like Hogat instead, or Go instead, is just focusing on a conventional center fight over here. Because there's the Rachel super hits value, the units that cost the most. Then it hits by infantry, how many infantry there are. It hits the most infantry. Then it hits the most units. So the most infantry will be hit over here. The most units will be hit over here. The most value will probably be hit somewhere else, where Hogat has medium tanks and whatnot. Go may choose to hang on to it one more turn, though, because he knows that two missiles will hit here, and it may be worth it to hold on to it later. But we'll see if he uses it immediately, because that copter is going to give him enough charge. Yeah, you can attack from the city over here, this copter, or even from this river. Doesn't matter which one, really. That will give you enough charge. Or you can attack this copter over here with the copter. I mean, this copter's going to attack one of the two. Probably going to attack the... Okay. He did that for the charge, and the KO. And due to this being a two-tower map, that knocked it out. Another thing, infantry in a two-tower map, 20% increase. You have guaranteed to hit KOs. Infantry attacking another infantry on a city. Two tanks attacking another tank on a city is also a guaranteed hit, two-hit KO. So when you have two towers, that's the difference between two towers and one tower. Under two towers, 20% bonus, you are guaranteed a two-hit KO. Of one unit attacking the same unit on a city. Tanks and infantry, that is. Recons are different and stuff like that, but... Okay. So, does not appear that Go is going to be going for over here. He's not going to exploit the Rachel missile to attack the bottom over here. Man, stop popping up, man. Okay. So he's getting dangerously close. He busted through the pipe scene with the artillery. The medium tank's in the middle. Very obvious where it is. You can see it. Using the recon to reveal the obvious artillery that we all knew there was from ages ago. But nothing can really reach it. There's a weakened tank can reach it. And an infantry can reach it. But that's about it. I think he might just be scrapping for some funds right now. Like I said, if you attack this medium tank to the copter, if you're desperate... you can get off the Rachel Super. But this kind of looks a little overextended, if I had to guess. Where are all Hogat's units? You'd expect to see more here, but it looks like they're all spread out in anticipation of the Super, hidden away. Maybe there's a bomber over here, maybe there's a Neo tank over here. We don't really know. So, looks like the medium tank is instead choosing to KO this infantry instead of getting the charge. So it looks like he's going to wait to use the charge for another day. That infantry just clearly saw the anti-air go over there, so he knows it's there. He knows there's an anti-air over there. It's pretty obvious. So Hogat's got pretty good vision. Honestly, if I'm Hogat, I probably want him to use the super just right away. Just get it over with, because I have the ball already. But
It is what it is. Let's see if Hogat is able to use Punish with an Urban Blight. I doubt you would use a High Society. There's niche situations where it's good, but I don't think there's enough income, enough cities to really justify it. I think two Urban Blights are a lot better than one High Society, roughly. So we'll see. But let's see what Go builds from over here. Is he going to continue another medium check and have three in the medium tech chain? That'd be pretty cool, I guess. Nope, going for the arrow over here. I think he has ideas of punishing now. Okay. Damn, he's building this strong... I guess the thing now is he's not really fighting the two base. He's reinforcing the middle. So instead, what he builds right here is actually going backwards to the middle rather than going forwards to the two base over here. So it makes sense to build more on the front lines. This is basically a forward base at this point. These ones are going to take ages to get the tank over here. So you might as well be building tanks here, recons, artillery, medium tanks, what have you. But the airport's quite far away, so it takes a little bit longer to reinforce with air. Let's see if Hogat chooses to use an Urban Blight here. An Urban Blight might come this turn. Maybe he's waiting it out. Okay. He's not going to use the super, is he? I mean, he could get a pretty strong hit on the tank, I guess. Oh, shit. If he kills that infantry and attacks with something from their city, I bet that's a two-hit KO. Use the super, or maybe even a normal power. You attack the tank with the artillery, then you follow up with a copter, and that medium tank is probably dead. Kindle copter attacking from a city during a power or a superpower to that medium tank is probably dead. And then you have ideas of attacking the artillery afterward, but I don't think there's enough things in... If he had a bunch of tanks here, that would be so devastating. You kill the mech, you kill the medium tank, then you kill the artillery, then you kill the anti-air. That would be like, you win the game. But it looks like Hogat's units are just dispersed across the map. That's the influence of Rachel. Not even using the power, but just dispersing all of Hogat's units. Must be really frustrating facing Rachel in that respect. So, it looks like... Okay, he's like sort of retreating. He's allowing these copters to be killed, but those anti-air will be punished. Shift up some stuff here to make an infantry wall, I would assume. Finish off that tank as well to deny vision. He's only using an infantry to attack it. Where is all his units? What the heck? I'm so curious. Hogat's gotta have a shit ton of funds. Where are they? But, oh man. Where are Hogat's units? This is like... I'm curious. I might have to look at the replay afterward. Like, where the heck are those units? The suspense is killing me. Like, what does he have in store? There's got to be, like, a massive push coming. Maybe from over here. Maybe from over here. Maybe, like, bombers, like I said earlier. Maybe two bombers. One kills the medium tank, one kills the anti-air, and then there's no counterplay. Like, I have no idea. Where are the units? Hashtag findhogatsunits.com. What if hashtags were also websites? I'm just joking. I don't even understand these things. I'm a half boomer by heart, I suppose. I don't do the TikToks. I just play this game in chess. I'm an old man. Alright. So, alright, well, see what Hogat does. Just wait and see. Okay, there's a tank at least. You gotta start putting shit in the force and whatnot. Hell, you got so much time, he's probably getting a rockets at this point. But although a rockets is susceptible to the super, so... It's hard to bunch up units with that super. It's so annoying to face Rachel. I bet Hogat's like, damn, I shouldn't have used Rachel in the first matchup. Because she's pretty OP. One thing for Hogat, though. Time. He's got time. But like I said, Go has not cracked under pressure yet. I don't think he will crack now in terms of time. So we'll see. Go can just start murdering things. Kill off that copter. Bring in the medium tank, kill that, bring in some artillery. Yeah, like, he can just run, just go to town. How is he going to stop and then bring this medium tank in? Oh, okay. Interesting. Only one missile hit over here. What the heck? So where did the other two hit? That is curious. Okay. And Hogat has not used an Urban Blight yet. That's all. These guys are holding on to their powers like there's no tomorrow. Go, I understand. He's been holding on to his power since last match when he was Kindle. And there's still, like, influence from not using the Rachel superpower because they're like, oh, I can't bunch up my units yet. That makes sense. But Hogat, I don't know why he hasn't been spamming Urban Blight so far. I mean, he's losing a bunch of charge. Okay, there are some units. 2 artillery and a tank. Okay, there we have some sort of budget units over here. Risky business to bring in this medium tank over here, but it's possible. Wait a minute. One of the covering fire hit over here, because this was definitely like 7 HP or something, I think. So I think one of the missiles hit over here. One of the missiles hit over here. God knows where the other missile hit. So, seemed like a pretty effective covering fire. I mean, if I'm go, I'm pretty happy that only one hit over here. That means 2 hits, some pretty good value somewhere else. So, maybe there's bombers. Maybe the bomber, the Neo tank, is what got hit. But he's just overcoming Hogat right here. So, he's, not attacking with the medium tank, he's attacking with these wimpy little units. He's just teasing him. He's just tickling. Killing off the units with all these weak little shits. Little rugrats. So, let's see. Go. Yeah, still at the... He's still, he was like at 3 minutes before, so he still has like 30 seconds more break even with the increments. He's not worried at all, I don't think. He's feeling pretty good at this point. I think Go has the lead for sure at this point. That Rachel super looked like it was pretty strong. If this was down to like 1 HP, I'd be like, oh shit, there's a big counterattack coming here. But since only one missile hit here, a little dubious. Looks like some other strong stuff was over here. Maybe there's like a Neo tank in this forest that got struck. Maybe there's bombers that got struck. I don't know. But only one missile over there. Go's got to feel pretty good about that. And what's Hogat going to do? Just start spamming Urban Blight? I mean, or he's going to use a super. I don't know. But there's not enough stuff to like kill using the super, I don't think, yet. So we'll see. And what is he going to do with this anti? It's kind of out of position over here. It defends against the air. Oh. Okay. He's in artillery range, but he feels probably good about it, I guess. He wants to put on the pressure while he has the super active. So he's expecting all these things to be weakened. So I guess he's going for the throat. Okay, there's a tank over here. So there's probably like some other crap in the other forest. Yeah, oh my god, he's going for attack on the strong side. On his own weak side against the Hogat's strong side. He is going balls to the wall. Oh man. Shit. Hogat's all his forces seems to be over here. Alright. So Go's doing the pincer. All his forces are over here. Hogat's is kind of like isolated over here. Go's is all together in this nice crescent moon attack. That's scary. And Hogat doesn't have vision of this mountain over here. Alright, let's see if Hogat can punish this. If he's got any air units, kills that, and attacks from the city, that medium tank is going to get one shot. And he's got to be happy that artillery lived too, because if you use a sap power or a superpower, that's going to do a shit ton. He used a super! Alright, this is going to... Balls to the wall, let's go, baby. What's he going to do? Boom! Okay, well, he sees all this now. Okay. Maybe a power would have been better. Okay, so he's going all out over here, it seems. I don't think his super is that strong. It looked like it only gave him like a 30 or 40% increase in firepower. I mean, from the city, it's going to one-hit KO. Oh, yeah, that's probably going to be one-hit KO attacking that... I think that's a one-hit KO. That's how strong the super is. Ooh, nice KO there. Nice KO there. One-hit KO that penguin, one-hit KO that artillery. Oh, shit, this is turning into a actually good counterattack. Okay. All right, Hogat, I see you. Kindle super, baby, let's go. But what's he going to do about these threats over here? There's 3 threats over here. I can see him killing the medium tank, and I can see him killing this artillery, but these over here are a different story. This thing is going to do a shit ton of damage. Interesting. But you can't just leave these two. Alright. Well, it's going to come down to what other tricks Hogat has in his bag over here. Clearly something was hit by... Oh, it didn't even attack the medium tank. Okay, at least that's dead. Kill this infantry. This mech one-shots it. So... Or just normal infantry will one-shot it. I think if infantry at like 8 HP probably one-shots it. That's how strong. I think you have like 110% increase or some crap during the superpower. Like, you do a lot of damage from the superpower from a city. So like anything. If you attack a tank to a medium tank, I think it does like 4 damage from like a city. It does a lot of damage. Yeah, one-shot. Oh... Damn, I thought that was for sure was a one-shot. And interesting. Okay. Bring in the artillery again, like daring him to stay in artillery range again. Seems Hogat went really heavy on the artillery in this game. Already seen four artillery shown. But doesn't look like he has any answer over here. He's dangerously close to the airport. He's airport locked. Why is he using it? Okay, I guess he's looking for any other possible tricks that Go might have, but that's not even a great exchange right there. That's kind of just weird. Yeah, he doesn't have anything to punish. I thought he might at least have like a bomber or some crap or a neo-tank, but I guess, I don't know where his money is. Where is all the money? These things are cheap. Where is the money? Where's that Hogat cash? You know, he's got a hog hat, but he doesn't have a piggy bank, apparently. Like, this copter can come in. If you kill this anti-air, this copter can come in and attack this. Oh no, never mind, it can't. It does have coverage. So, okay, it doesn't have quite impunity. Retreat? This is kind of a wimpy super. I mean, it's not terrible, but... Oh my god, he's got away. This guy's got away scot-free! Scot-free, whatever. Alright, Go chooses to attack from the city rather than capping. I guess he can also join, make it a 10 HP infantry if he so chooses. This is pretty precarious, though. You're pretty overextended in your strong side, or their strong side and your weak side. But Go seems to be... I mean, it paid off. He went into the belly of the beast, and he lived to say tell the tale, apparently, so far. So many artillery by Hogat. Versus Rachel, that's kind of dubious. So I'm not sure if I agree with this artillery spam. There's got to be a shit ton of artillery hit. Like, where's the money? Where's the meat? Yeah, the tank kills, or the medium tank kills the tank. Oh. That was hiding in the forest earlier when it got hit by the covering fire. Oh, there was a medium tank. Why didn't he attack medium tank to medium tank, though? Remains to be seen. Looks like he's trying to get an avenue in to punish these artillery, but it's easier said than done. You can, yeah, you kill off that 2 HP infantry, and then you recon. That's a roll. You use the power. There's two. It's a roll, right? Nope. Okay, two powers turn the tide. So he will be able to bring that in and kill the copter. Oof. That copter was not able to be saved. So he's getting punished a bit right now. Bringing this artillery. Looks like this artillery is going to live, though, and it's on a city. So even if it's going to only have 4 HP or 1 HP, depending on this copter attacks, or 3 HP rather, it's still going to do a heck of a lot of damage. So we'll see. Okay. Oh, that guy just got brutalized. I think that was a full HP infantry attack that city. And the 6 HP infantry did 9 damage back. My goodness. Okay, copter over here. Hogat's got to have an anti-air at this point, though, I would assume. Picking off some easy kills. Artillery is going to fire, though, and kill that tank, or at least severely damage it, that other artillery. Oh, but he's got to kill this anti-air somehow. Huh. Yeah, there you go. Punish. So this artillery is going to pick its poison. It's going to die. Was it going to shoot on the tank, or medium tank, or is it going to shoot on artillery? Personally, I'd shoot on that artillery, because it's on a road. This medium tank's on a plane, so you're going to do less damage. Plus, you have this medium tank over here that can also just cream one of these units. Oh, if he has a bomber or some shit, you murder the anti-air, then you kill the medium tank. Okay, killed that unit over there. Probably going to kill off that penguin. Boom. Alright. Okay, we're at the hour mark. We're at the hour mark of day 16. We're halfway there. Oh my god. This is probably going to turn into another 2-hour game, let's be honest. Okay. Okay, anti-air to anti-air. And he repairs it. Okay, he was going to go for the 2-hit KO, I guess. Alright. Yes. Okay, so he's killing with a recon. Okay, medium tank to medium tank. That's a pretty decent exchange. I mean, 5 damage done, 2 damage back. Can't really complain. It's used to attack with the artillery. Why didn't he attack with the artillery first? He must have realized too late. Wait, why? Oh, he doesn't see the vision of the tank over here. Oh, yeah, you definitely want to shoot the tank. You don't want to shoot a recon. Interesting. Vision denial is playing an important role so far. I don't think he has enough units to like fight off this these two anti-air. It looks like Go's push is pretty sustained. Fortunately for Hogarth, this medium tank does not overlap with that one, so we will not be completely clobbered by a counterattack, but looking a little dubious. I'm wondering... to this day, I don't know where Hogarth's money has gone. It's like in a bank account in Panama or some crap. I mean, he has one medium tank, but Ghost has gotten 3 so far. Remains to be seen. So, Hogarth, plenty of time. Go has 21 seconds. He'll get two minutes in an increment every time, so not a huge deal. He did the same with Tordred, no big deal. 2 minutes, 20 seconds, this is normal. Yeah, it goes fine. He's not going to use Lucky Lass. Lucky Lass takes too much time to calculate and think about. You just want to be, like, baboon-brained and just blast with covering fire ASAP. Make your opponent think and plan around the covering fire rather than just immediately using Lucky Lass. See, good vision. I like this. I like stopping the cap here and instead focusing on the vision. Smart move. Now you see that there's no real threat. And actually, he would have made... He's airport blocking it anyway, so it's probably a good thing he didn't build anything. But, damn. Goes, went away for a little bit, and he's under 2 minutes, so he's, okay. Vision. Yeah, hit there. You might have been able to do a hit and then attack with that medium tank, though. Okay, he's really spamming these anti-air now. 1, 2, 3. This one's 4. He's going to die. Still fighting near these artillery, which I'm not quite sure about. And you don't want to bring this medium tank to attack an artillery, because the other one's just going to blast at the kingdom come. Is this go attack running out of steam, or is it going to be able to be sustained? That is the question. And he needs to get some compensation out of it. So far, he's been able to prevent this property in the meantime, and he's threatening to take this property, but will he be able to hold it? Because he's getting pretty close to the two base over here. 2 turns away, medium tank is already going to be attacking units over here. This artillery is going to, or this anti-air is going to be killing a copter unless he attacks with his own artillery, which is going to get blasted. So it's a little, also can repair the artillery of, or the anti-air. Oh, smart move. Because vision denial is really real right now for Go. Gogat has no idea what's going on. He's got no vision. Whoa. Interesting. Is he... Okay. It's not terrible. I mean, I think that did 2 damage. That wasn't a bad thing after all. Medium tank to this tank. See, he had to use the tank out of here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. To see this recon. He doesn't even see this tank. Oh my goodness. He has no vision. That is nutty. That is so nutty. He doesn't have any recons. He has no vision. Wow. That must suck. Yeah. What do you do? Like, if he had vision, he'd kill that with his medium tank and then kill the copter with the anti-air, but he doesn't have vision, which sucks. Damn, that's frustrating. Should have had a recon last turn, but he didn't build one. He would have been able to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and get vision of all this. Well, not the anti-air because it's in the forest, but enough to kill the tank. Ooh, that's so frustrating. I hate that. I hate being denied vision. Vision is king. And, okay, so these basically got free hits. I mean, he can look back at the replay and see that they attack, so he knows they're there. It's not like they just disappeared. He knows they're there, he just needs to be able to see them, which is one of the most frustrating things. You know they're there, but how do I even get to glance at them? Vision is going to be the difference at this turn. Will it be the end of Hogarth because of that? Oh my god, he used the anti-air just to see. Not even to kill. Just to see, to kill one single tank. Man, that's annoying. Still airport locked, by the way. Still airport locked by that Antair. Can't build a copter. And there you have it. Hogat resigns. Oh, man. Wow. Go had a really good KD and income, too. I don't know what it even would say, but, like, wow, that was... And I thought Hogat was the favorite. Go is... King Penguin has earned his name. The crown is officially his. He wins in normal fog matches in Global League, and he wins in live versus the very best of the best. Wow. Damn, that was impressive. My god, the vision denial, the fake out over here to switch to the middle, and then the planning to get this medium tank immediately reinforced at the same time. Never allowed that. I'm in awe. And then he did the unthinkable. He went for an offensive and was not punished. He, like, how did he know that there was enough units over here that he wouldn't have enough of it? Like, this is just, like, oh, man, I'm just so impressed. I'm so impressed. I actually am the most impressed by this attack over here that paid off. He got a bunch of kills and was able to cap, and there was nothing to really do anything back. That was so impressive. Wow. And if you saw Hogat's last game, he is no slouch. He is a really, really, really good player. He's better than any of you guys. Sorry, just throwing it out there. Wow. Whew, that was intense. And, where were Hogat's units? Where was the money at? I want to know where the money went. During the super, where... Go add, like, a bunch of medium... Yeah, two medium tanks. What the hell? He just had a bunch of artillery, I guess. Wow, he's really far behind in funds. Wow. I guess he was saving up? Maybe he was saving up, but I guess he was behind. It's a small income map. I guess the 18,000, 19,000 gradually wore him down. Just not a good fight right there. Pretty even at this point. You use the super, and that just, oof, hard to come back. And then you use the super, Kindle super. It wasn't terrible. Did 30,000 in damage, not terrible. But Urban Blight wouldn't be that much better, to be perfectly honest. Go is not touching the cities, he's treating them like lava. So, so impressive. I guess Hogat just didn't have the funds. Go was able to pump out medium tanks every turn. Two infantry and a medium tank every turn. I guess theoretically Hogat could, but he was doing heals and repairs. So he wasn't able to sustain that same amount of big beefy units that Go was. And that recon at the beginning, let's see at the beginning, opening. Early recon. Hogat, later recon, didn't build from the front one either. You should build from the front one, not from this back one over here. Got into the fight later, took two turns to see this rather than just one turn to see this and interrupt an attack. So, that recon paid off too. I'm just so impressed. Wow. Thank you everyone for tuning in to the Fog Goblin Goblet. The winner this year for 2022 is Mr. Go7. Well deserved. Just want to give him a round of applause. Great player, great person. He has a YouTube channel. I'll just plug it right now at the very end. Go7 has his own YouTube channel. It's on. There's like there's a scale of entertainment and, you know, knowledge to this game. Mangs is on the entertainment side of Advanced Wars, where it's like very entertaining and funny, lighthearted and whatnot. And then on the other end, there's like Go7 and Tordred, where it's more serious, more calculating, more really going to the facts of Advanced Wars. I like to consider myself in the middle. I'm kind of a dabbler. This is the only time I dabble. I dabble in the entertainment, but at the same time, I want to give my expertise as well. But Go7 has a very expertise channel. If you're into the weeds, if you want to know calculations behind his attacks, like the really nitty gritty to get you the very top echelons, you should check out his channel. Very impressed with his play, needless to say. Holy shit. Thank you everyone for tuning in. I love you all. Thanks for keeping Advanced Wars alive. Even after this reboot camp had some issues. And I hope to see you guys next time, next episode. Next, maybe there's a Fog Goblin Goblet again. We'll see. The Fog Goblin Goblet. Again, we'll see. Anyway, I hope to see you guys again soon. Goodbye.